keep up if you can. Of death. You're on dangerous ground. You're so eager to die. Fight evil. Do this. You're so eager to die.
Mademoiselle, might I have a word? I consider myself an expert in the culinary arts, that's cooking food to you. But I have not been able to practice my true skill these many years. My master taught me his greatest recipes, but together we only made them but one time. Now the world stands on the edge of destruction, and I fear I will never make them again.
I'd like to help, but about the only dish I can cook is Behemoth's steak on a campfire.
What I need is much simpler than that. I require only a few small but vital ingredients.
Which you can't find.
Exactement. Especially in this day and age.
All right. If I find any, I'll bring them to you.
Mademoiselle, merci beaucoup. With those ingredients, I'll once again be able to craft the masterpieces of my forebears.
It's been so long. You seem to be doing well.
Compared to Luxurian, things aren't as convenient, but it's not so bad. Come on, I'll show you around the village. Oh, and remember, don't stray too far from the path. It's not safe.
Thank you, dear. I'll be sure to remember that.
I can't think of a bond stronger than the love between a mother and child.
Are you all right?
I used to have family too. A sweet little thing who I adopted as my own. How I loved her.
Where is she now?
She's gone. But she was the sweetest thing, always following me around. Her fur was the softest of all animals.
Fur? What? You mean... Oh, wait. You're talking about a pet.
A dog, yes. But she was so much more than that. Her name was Clove. She was my only family. One day I lost sight of her for a split second. And she just never came home. Even though I loved her like my own, she probably didn't feel the same about me.
I've never been able to forget those fireworks, though it's been 10 years at least. I came to see them again, but nearly got caught by a security bot. Oh, I tell you, I won't do this again.
I spent ages screwing up my courage for the experience of a lifetime. So I joined the tour. And it almost ended up being the last experience of my life. That was way too close.
Hello there. Is your... Hello! I'll cook you up something. Thank you, ma'am.
I've got a new tour going.
Things look quiet here. You're not running any sneaking in specials?
Hey, it's you! Welcome back! You're not gonna believe how perfect your timing is. We've got monsters infesting the whole industrial area. Things I've never seen before. When life gives you lemons, make lemonade, right? So I've created a new tour, an extreme action-adventure vacation right here. Death Safari, a battle against ferocious monsters. I came up with the title myself.
But let me guess, no takers yet, right?
Bunch of wimps, these tourists. But not like you, though. You can handle anything. Why don't you go in there and kill all the monsters? Clean the place out. You'd be doing me a favor, so I could offer you a discount on the usual rate.
So you want me to pay for the privilege of helping you?
Did I say discount? I meant to say 100% free, no charge.
Okay, I'll do it. So all you want from me is to fight any monsters I come across. Nothing fancy, right?
That's the spirit! I knew you'd be into it! And yeah, just fight them as they come. But bring back any items they drop so we can make a tally.
Anything else I should know?
Just the usual stuff. You know how it works. No guarantees, at your own risk. Don't blame us if you die, etc., etc. Good luck.
Get it if you want to die. Time you met your maker. Pray for the dead.
You think you can be forgiven? Time you met your maker. Change course. Tears fall into the chaos. Repent. go and wait for a new dawn.
Just fight any monsters. Don't forget to collect.
Feel like dying? Pray for the dead. At the edge of death.
Adventure tour. Any feedback for the next one?
It might be too dangerous for regular tourists. On the other hand, I found it too easy, to be honest.
Too easy, huh? I had a feeling you might say that, which is why I've laid on a special bonus tour, and here's the ticket. It's a special event being held in the Warehouse District, invitation only. If you head over to the warehouses, you'll find Biggs waiting for you. Just show him the ticket.
A special event? You mean a dangerous event, right? I'm interested.
You bet it's dangerous. I guarantee it. Except that's against company policy. You know, lady, you're a real inspiration to the likes of me. It's too late for me in this life. But if I do end up being reborn, I'm gonna grab life by the reins and make something of myself. Say, tell me your name. You know, just in case we meet in the next world. Mine's Wedge.
I'm Lightning. And I'll see you around, Wedge.
Lightning! I've been expecting you. Glad you could make it.
So you're Wedge's friend, is that right?
That's right. Biggs is the name. I'm in charge of the special event that we're running here in the Warehouse District. A little something we call Death Game.
Sounds exciting enough.
Oh, it is. Tell you what, join the event, see for yourself.
All right, I'll play your game, but on one condition. If I get through this event and win it, you'll have to do me a favor.
Huh? What? You want more bonus money? Look, it's already a pretty generous payout, you know. Tell you what, I'll think about it.
It's not money, and it might be to your advantage, too. But I'll tell you what it is after I've done the event.
All right, fine. If you're gonna hold me to promises that you won't even tell me, then I'm gonna add some conditions of my own. The rules are gonna be a bit more strict.
Just remember our deal.
Yeah, I've got it. You get to ask a favor. But only if you can win under the new, harder rules, all right?
Just ran out. Do you dream of death? Keep up if you can. You're so eager to die. Time to repent. Pray for the dead. Evil has a price. Tears fall into the chaos. You think you can be forgiven? You're gonna regret this. Keep up if you can. You think you can be forgiven? You're gonna regret this. You're down. I won't go easy on you. Accept death. Pray for rebirth.
That's it, just a few more!
Up if you can. Our tears fall into the chaos. You owe me.
Our deal? Right. Don't worry, I hadn't forgotten. So, what is it you want me to do?
Shut down the death game. Now.
Shut down? But I...
I saw the skeletons in there. Those are the remains of other players, right? I know what this is for. People who are tired of endless life come out here for a last taste of excitement. People shouldn't die for a game. Even if that's what they want.
Okay, people get killed in there, but... That's not what it's about. Our customers wanted thrills, see? They were looking to put the zip back in their lives, and we gave them that chance.
I get it, but it's gone too far. It's not about fun or excitement. Not anymore.
Yeah, maybe you're right. We crossed a line and didn't even know it. It's time to put the fun back into our events.
North of here lies a desolate land that's littered with the hulks of downed airships. Hardly anyone goes there, apart from the curious and the brave. If you manage to trek across that land, you'll eventually reach one particular airship wreck. There's a man who lives in that wreckage, a recluse who's turned his back on the rest of human society. Of course, he's not the only recluse to make his way out to the wildlands, but this one stands out with his giant nest of a haircut. I hear he used to be a pilot back in the day.
You are truly one of the few people who dare travel here. This is a terribly desolate place. A graveyard for many wrecked airships. Perhaps this is the result of the wave of destruction that occurred 500 years ago.
See something? Oh, thanks a lot.
Huh? This is private property.
Hi! Hello there!
You're Dr. Ghazal's assistant, but who are you?
Tilda. I'm a doctor around here. We have a bit of a problem, I'm afraid. So I was just consulting with the assistant here.
He doesn't look happy. Is he injured?
Something is wrong, that's for sure. We just found him. He's ever so weak.
Oh, poor thing. But he'll be all right, with a vet and a doctor looking after him.
Right. This clever vet was just telling me about an effective medicine that should help.
I'm still just a trainee. Dr. Ghazal is the clever one. I just run errands. But I'm going to help this little one get better.
He'll stay with me for the first little while. Not that I know much about dogs. I usually treat people, obviously. All I need to do is have him drink the assistant's medicine. I can handle that.
Good news for the dog. I'm sure he'll get better soon.
He would, except...
Except?
Well, we're out of ingredients to make the medicine.
Yeah, that's the problem, see?
I could collect the ingredients for you.
Yes, you could. I mean, it's not like you'd have to go to the ends of the world to find them, or anything like that. The assistant can give you a list of what we need. This girl, she's actually more clever than she lets on.
Oh no, I'm not. I still hardly know anything at all. But I do know how to help the dog. He just needs the right medicine and he'll be fine.
Okay then, tell me what you need. And I should give these to Tilda, right?
Yes, please. Oh, thank you so much for helping out. Well, I've got to run. Dr. Ghazal will be expecting me back at Canopus Farms.
Everyone is very...
I want to thank you on behalf of Canopus Farms.
Why would they be excited? According to your own legends, it's an evil omen.
Aye, that's true enough. Some people even call it the harbinger of death. But even so, we don't fear it. We already know this world is about to be swallowed up by the chaos. But the thing is, when that happens, we believe that we'll be reunited with our loved ones who passed before. The end will be terrible, but there's hope on the other side.
So that's the Wildlands religion.
I don't know if I'd go so far as to call it a religion. But yeah, we don't follow the city folk beliefs. They think that a messenger from God called the Savior will appear out of nowhere. Then this Savior is going to take them to a new promised land. Now, I'm not one to judge other people's beliefs, but personally, it just sounds like wishful thinking. But then, I suppose the folk praying in the Order's churches don't put much stock in our beliefs either. That's fine with me. I've always said everyone's entitled to believe what they want. I just hope everyone gets what they're looking for in the end. And for us, that just means being with our families again. How are things? We grow Ghazal greens right here in the village. There's a man and his daughter who have their own field.
I think your chocobo is strong enough.
I'll ride him, if you think he's ready. But by rights, it should be you. You were the one who tracked him all those years, and saved him from his injuries.
I'm too old to ride a chocobo like that. And do you think I'd go gallivanting into that temple, looking for the great chaos? No, my place is here, to help you fulfill your destiny.
That white chocobo's a fine-looking animal, ain't he? You take good care of him.
The wildlands are dangerous at night.
Have I told you about the wild herb that chocobos sometimes eat? Well, I call it an herb, but really it's a kind of flower. The hunters of Yagd know the places where it grows.
For that job.
Sarah, are you there? Can you hear me?
Yes. Yes, I can hear you. I've been waiting for such a long time just to see you. But I'm coming home now. It's been a long journey, and it's almost over. I've got so many things I want to tell you.
Yeah, me too.
Lightning, you're just like I remember. We haven't seen each other for so long, but you won't let on that you're glad.
You're my sister. You know me better than that. Like you always tell me, I don't wear my heart on my sleeve.
Yeah, the number of times Snow and I tried to get you to crack a smile, but we never could, except for that one time. You've always been like that. Even when we were kids. But Light, when you've done your mission and I come back, promise me that you'll smile for me then, okay?
Sarah was right. Ever since I could remember, even as a child,
I always kept my feelings deep inside. But this time, it wasn't a mask, and I wasn't hiding my joy. When I saw Sarah, I didn't feel anything at all. It's like whatever love I'd had for her was gone from my heart. Sacred Tree of Light.
You survived another day. Fang is going to do now? Will she try to break into the Order's cathedral and stop the ceremony?